Okay, hi, this is Wanda again. We're now inside the house. You enter this door is on the patio side, and you walk into a beautiful sitting room. Try to imagine what your furniture would look like in here. Okay, and here, you have beautiful hardwood floors, and this is the living room. So your front door here. Okay. So in the front here, you have a small section of bricked area and a couple steps up. You do have the fireplace is brick and wood burning?
No, it'll have to be hooked up to gas.
Oh, okay.
Well, they put the new roof on, they eliminated the chimney.
Okay, all right. You can tell this house has been treated and maintained very well. Huge windows in the front. There's lots of light in. Okay, we're gonna walk here to the left. Okay, you could make this a dining room or whatever you want. It's a nice roomy space, and again, you have the hardwoods. They have a gate lid table in here. That would be a great idea. Okay, this goes to the bedroom. Okay, we'll see that in a minute. Okay. All right. And here, of course, is the kitchen. And you have nice tiles, neutral color. And your countertops are also a neutral color. And your stove is really big. I love the range with so much space on it. Okay. You have pretty white cabinets, and they have really nice door pulls, as you can see. And have a nice big window to the outside for washing dishes. You can certainly open that. And more cabinets over here. And refrigerator, obviously. And let's see. Okay, that's regular cabinets. Okay. All right, so you have some corner cabinets. You have your dishwasher, of course. And then under here, you have your under sink area for clean cleansers and things like that. And then you have several drawers. Okay, here. Your stove is right here. Cabinets above it, a drawer below. Yeah, a drawer below, and then two more cabinets behind here. Plenty of storage. Okay. All right, we're going to go from here into the laundry area. And you have another sink in here. I think it's cast iron. It feels like it's really sturdy. I would say cast iron with enamel on top, but, you know, I could be wrong on that, but I think you'll like it. Okay, plenty more cabinets and drawers. Okay, for your laundry, the appliances that come with the home are the dishwasher, range, refrigerator, and the security alarm. Always a good thing to have. Okay, so your washer dryer hookups are back there. This opens up, and you can have some more storage space. Okay. We're going to go down the basement in a minute. Okay. All right. I'm going to go to the or where the bedrooms are. Okay. There's one nice size room. The beautiful hardwood floors continue in here. And you could easily get a queen size bed in here. And this is the master, so it does have the ensuite bath with a stand-up shower. Very nice cabinet or countertops. Very pretty. Okay. So this is accessible to guests as well as to the master bedroom. Shower head. I that may stay, but I'll check on that if you're interested in the home. All right, let's come in here. We have another sitting room. You could make this your TV room or kids' playroom. Anything that you want to do. It's a very nice space. Lots of light, as you can see. You can pull the blinds up and let them open. You have four big windows in here. Let's see. Closet space here. Okay. Oh, okay. Let me close this. All right, so this, the bathroom also opens to this area. You see what size furniture will fit in here. They've got overstuffed furniture and it fits nicely. So you have textured ceilings, but not popcorn. Okay, back to this bedroom. Okay, this house does have three bedrooms and two baths. And here is a big closet. Back over there. Plenty of room to put clothes and things like shoes at the bottom, or duffel bags, or whatever you want to put. Okay. All right. Here is the other bath. And this is accessible at the hallway. Linen closet here. Lots of space. Beautiful tile work on this tub shower combo. And you can see they even have the popular glass tiles that really make a space to sparkle. And the other tile is an upgraded tile. You see that? And you have a beautiful vanity, high-end faucet. You have a sculptured sink in the middle. Okay, space underneath, two drawers. I can't find the light switch. The hardest part of my job is finding the light switches. Sometimes they hide from me. Oh, okay, there it was. Okay. So you have a large bedroom here. They have two beds, and you can see the hardwood floors continue. These hardwoods are in great shape. This house was built in 1950. And you don't find floors this good very often of houses that are built in the 50s. But this is beautiful hardwood. Okay, you have a large size closet from there to there. go to, this is right next to, here's your sitting room in here. And when we take a right, come in the corner, in the hall, and turn the corner, here is another bedroom. So this is your third bedroom. Nice big closet, the hardwood floors continue in here. And so picture if your furniture would work in here. That's always important. This, I would say, maybe a queen bed, might be a double. Back in that era when the house was built, they didn't have bedrooms built for king beds because that wasn't a thing back then. But I think you could easily get a queen bed in here. Closet space. Now, go back here and go find the basement. Find the basement place. Okay, I opened the door that had the basement access. Right there. Oh, okay. Thanks. Right here? Oh, yeah. Thanks. Okay. So we're going to go upstairs. Check this out. I like that it has carpet on the stairs. Makes it a little easier to come down and off. Down here, find the lights. Trying to find if there's a light switch. Well, you can see the basement as I'm walking through. It gets natural light on this side. Our basement looks very dry, which is a very good thing. Okay, they do have a sump pump, and they have a service alarm for you, so you can check. You see when it's last been serviced. Looks like a gas connector. So if you wanted okay, the fuel is electric. This may have had gas in the past, and they capped it off. That's something you can check on. We can check on if you want to make an offer. This, you have a really nice basement air system to keep it from getting moist down here and causing mold and problems like that. I can find out what the solar system is. This is a drain pipe or something. And it's been tapped off. Here's your HVAC system. Lots of shelving, lots of space. Mm-hmm. It's a little darker over here. I couldn't, it's not giving an outside light. As you can tell, they have lots of storage space down here. Just brought in some tables, put things on them. You could certainly put shelves down here. Anything that you want. I really need a light in here. Okay. Okay. This is for storage, I believe, and let's see. Sorry, I can't find the light switch. Okay, well, this is a, looks like a storage area. And I'm sorry that I can't show you any more than I can show you, but it is a concrete block. And this door is door to the outside. This could, I don't know. I'm not sure what that is, but there is a door to the outside. And we're going to go back out here. You want to check corners, especially the basements. And just so that you know the process, you may already know this, but I'll tell you just in case. When you put an offer on a house and it's accepted, then you're under contract. Right after being under contract, we have 15 days to arrange your home inspection, and the home inspector will of course inspect everything and give you a report of narrative plus pictures, and then we make a list of things that you want to have repaired or replaced in some cases, and then we negotiate from there. You know, if it's really bad, then that's a different situation, but you do have a home inspection. And that's a contingency on the contract. So if something were really bad on that, you can walk away from the deal. Or what we try to do is negotiate things. Either a price difference, price reduction, or a concession, cash concession at closing to fix things yourself. Number of things that we can do. So I'll help you with all that. So we're going to go back up. Beautiful kitchen again. Okay. Light switch. Oh. Oh, okay.
Because I'll lock your plane up. It's not a big deal.
All right, thanks. Okay, well, that's the house. So I hope you like it. And when you get the video, if you have any questions at all, just call me. If I don't know from the information I have, I'll reach out to the listing agent and find out answers for you. Okay, thank you so much for joining me today, and I look forward to meeting you. Bye-bye.